Onyx Technologies is a Norwegian robotics company, and at the end of August, it announced that its latest robot, the Neo, is going to be entering beta. Now, its previous robot, the Eve, was kind of its prototype robot, a robot specifically designed for industrial or work tasks. It had arms, but it had pincers for hands instead of normal working hands, and it didn't have legs. It had wheels. So the Neo, in comparison, is a huge refinement on the Eve model because it looks humanoid. It is humanoid. It has arms and legs and hands that move, and it moves by walking on its legs. So what can it do? Allow me to show you. It will be able to move around the home naturally and help with household chores and tasks. It can move items and help with the cleaning. It can pick up delicate objects like a glass jar or an egg without cracking it, and I'll show you that later. So it can really be useful in a number of ways in helping you. It's 5'4" tall and 66 pounds. And the movement in the video does look very realistic, so much so that some people have speculated that it's actually a person, a human, in a suit, pretending to be a robot. Now, quite apart from the fact that this would be really foolish for a company to do, because it would undermine their whole product and effectively damage them. Look, let's have a look at some of the comments. Twitter user Ryan Hoover, he says, "That's definitely a dude in a suit." Dar, who works for 1X, he says, "We'll prove it to you in person. Too much IP under the hood, so suit is staying on." Haha. When you're in the Bay Area, San Francisco Bay, we'll have you down or we'll catch you at Jimmy Douglas. Okay. So, you know, they're offering to show it. That's really good. A show of confidence. And in fact, there have been a couple of other videos where they're showing it moving. 1X is showing it moving in its offices in Sweden. And what's probably drawing the attention of people is its human-like manner, and this is down to its physical design. So what 1X has decided to do is, rather than use the traditional components that would be used for a robot, to build a robot, such as hard levers and pistons and those sort of hard components, it has tried to replicate the movements of a human by using by replicating the muscle movements of a human. And so there's softer materials in there as well, but the movements are going to be more human-like in the way they move, such as the way the movement can the human arm can move to a certain point and then has its limitations on how far it can twist. And all the benefits of this is essentially that by not using traditional robotic components, it can cut down on energy costs, so it's going to use less power. It's going to then be less hot, and more than that, the movement's going to be human, but it's also, there's less risk of a robot performing a task that could hurt a human. So if you can imagine a robot arm that is fully a full piston, full hydraulics, and then it suddenly jerks out, that could do a lot of damage. Now, this is the CEO of 1X, Bert Bornick, and he's explaining a little bit more about how the Neo operates, its physicality.
So what's pretty unique about this is kind of like, just like for us humans, we have the motors up here with the tendons that are pulling, very similar to muscle. And this actually allows you to, for example, have two motors here together, drive the 2 degrees of freedom here. So just like for me, when I'm doing this and I'm doing this, it's the same muscles. So you don't have to carry as much muscle to have all this flexibility. And that's the same here. So you can see like this, it's the same. Due to having this bar-inspired approach to the joints, where your very low ratio strong motors are pulling the tendons, you get this very compliant, safe nature.
This inside structure that mimics the forms of humans means when it moves, it will look like a human. Look at that. Pretty compelling in what it can do and how it can move. So all this footage has been captured by a YouTube channel called S3, and they had the chance to have the robot stay, the guy who runs the channel had the chance to have the robot stay with him for a couple of days. it was an opportunity for him to get to see what it's like in a real world situation. It's a really brilliant channel, actually, S3, because they interview some people really at the cutting edge of future technology. So it's worth a look. Now, how does the Neo work? Well, of course it uses AI, but it uses a special variation, something called embodied learning. And this is where it combines models of training that has been previously taught, but also it's also learning as it goes along through the physical space in its everyday environment. So how it interacts with a table and a chair, this counts as learning, and it can help it better interact with those elements in the future. And this information is then used to also help 1X so that they can improve the models for other units going forward. The Neo, of course, will have safety mechanisms in place. And this is so 1X describes it as preventing unintended actions. And what can unintended actions be? Well, obviously, you don't need to think too hard. It could be that the robot suddenly turns around and hurts someone in some way, perhaps pushing them too hard. What 1X is saying is that it can actually be overtaken by a human operator in the case of an emergency as well. So hopefully it doesn't come to all of this. And in interviews, 1X have gone to great lengths to explain that this is a key area, a most important area to ensure safety of the Neo in an environment where there are people, adults, children, and vulnerable people. In the marketing materials, 1X don't refer to Neo as a he or a she or even an it. 1X refers to it as a they. Now, this is a gender-neutral pronoun, and I understand that perhaps it may be that the company wants to leave it to its owners to give the robot a gender. But for myself, it feels a bit weird to call an object a they. So I'm going to refer to the 1X Neo as an it. Now, at this moment in time, I'm sure there's not really going to be an issue with that. Nobody's going to take offense. But once these robots begin to roll out, I don't see it as entirely unfeasible that there will be some people taking exception to the idea that these robots are being referred to as it or objects. And they're going to not be happy about it. But and maybe they might even complain about people treating these robots as slaves. But that's further down in the timeline. So why is the Neo modeled after a human when it might be more efficient to have some sort of more square robotic design that's more adept at moving around the house? The simple reason is human psychology. As people, we react to certain different robotics in different ways. There have been plenty of tests for AI speakers such as Alexa and Siri to suggest that most people, men and women, react better to a female voice. And when it comes to a robot, this anthropomorphic design is something that we are more easily going to connect to because it seems more like what we are. We don't like objects that move sideways. They look like spiders. If we see an object, a robot that moves like us, then it can be like us, and we are more likely to see it as something that can fit in our household environment. We relate to a human more than a box with arms or a box with wheels. And this is because there is a nuance in human movement. And because the Neo has been designed so that it has this natural movement more than any of these other competing robots, then it's going to make it so much easier for us to relate to it. An analogy I can make is with the Star Wars film with Darth Vader. Now, you've got this big, bulky, evil-looking character, and he's got this huge robotic roles, this powerful robotic voice. And there are times when he's interacting with Luke Skywalker, I think it's the second film, Empire Strikes Back, and when this happens, he's not actually saying anything. There is this nuance with his movement and the way he's looking, and through that, you get a sense of who he is or what he's thinking, that he's human. And I think this is something that will work so well with the Neo robots. So, can it actually be useful? Well, the main thing is that it has to be able to actually perform tasks and not just walk around the house and not do too much. It has to be able to actually practically help you. And this will be tremendously useful for people who are stuck in the home, for people who've got physical disabilities, mobility issues, for elderly people. You know, if you can imagine an older person stuck at home, they don't have their children coming to visit them, and they can have this robot make them a cup of tea. And if it's using a chat model with it, then it can have a conversation, you know. And how good will that be to help improve the quality of life for people? Now, I want to show you the promotional trailer that was released for the announcement of the beta. So bear with me. Let me bring it up. Right. Let me set the scene. You've got the woman on her sofa getting ready to go out, and you've got her Neo robot waiting patiently to fulfill her needs. Okay.
Yeah.
Will I ever be enough for her? Right, okay. So let's go over that. He can see she's preparing to go out, and he points to the backpack, and she nods, and he passes it to her, right? So that's nice, that's sweet. But the music playing, it's like the music of a romantic comedy or a romance. He's looking quite forlorn here, the Neo. I'm giving him a he pronoun. Looking at his hands. Why is he looking at his hands? The way I interpret that is, he's thinking to himself, am I enough? And she comes back and into his arms. Right? So, it does suggest a very familiar relationship between the two of them. And this has, of course, been memed on the internet. So let me just find that for you. So this person says, love it, but why make him such a beta? And they put a red line indicating the angle of the Neo leaning into the woman. And this comes from modern dating psychological advice, which is that the person who leans in the most is the one who's most invested in the relationship. And... So the joke is that this Neo is more into her than she is into him. Oh, God. What 1X is saying with the Neo is it's going to have a very limited beta release at the end of this year, if still possible. And there's going to be a rollout next year. Perhaps 100 to 200 units being produced per month. And then they plan to scale the release so that many more units can be released over the course of 2026. And in terms of the cost, 1X is saying that it will cost the amount of an affordable car, not an LA car, a California car, but an affordable car. What that means, I don't know. That could be £15,000 to £20,000 or dollars. And if it actually makes a difference to people's lives, then it's a question of, is it worth it? What with the development of the Tesla Optimus and the Xiaomi Cyber One, I think what really makes the Neo stand out is that it has been designed specifically, not just to look humanoid, to be a humanoid device that can work in professional environments, in factories or whatever. It has been designed for the home. And so because of this, there is a huge responsibility for it to work well and for it to be safe and for people to be able to connect with it. And what 1X have done differently from the other companies, as yet it seems to be unique, is create this form, this physical structure that is lighter, that is less energy costly, that is more human-like in the way it moves. And this is going to potentially help it be more readily adopted than any of the other alternatives. So it's not going to be long until these are actually going to be available on sale. And come the mid-2030s, for those of us who manage to make it, come the mid-2030s, the robot age will be fully, truly upon us.